When we need to buy more inventory from our vendors, we usually create a purchase order and send it to them. A purchase order is a document that formally requests the merchandise, a document that asks the vendor to ship the merchandise for us so we can purchase it from them and sell it to the customer. As you can see, a purchase order is like any other document in QuickBooks, and we make a purchase order the same way we complete any other document that we previously learned about. It is an event that must be recorded in our financial records. However, even though we must have records of the purchase order is not a transaction. All you are doing when you make a purchase order is asking the vendor to send the merchandise. Maybe they will, maybe they will not. But the event of asking for the merchandise is not a full transaction. Therefore, the purchase order will not show in the journal. The purchase order will not have an effect on the trial balance or any of the balances of the accounts in the chart of accounts. Purchase orders have their own separate reports for you to manage what was ordered, what was received, and what you are waiting for. To manage your purchase orders, you must know what open purchase order means. An open purchase order is a purchase order that we have not yet received, even though we mailed out the document to the vendor. The best report to see this is on the Open Purchase Order Detail report. From the main menu, click Reports, Purchases, Open Purchase Order Detail. Open Purchase Order Detail. This report shows everything you need after you start recording purchase orders and start receiving them. You will see this will help you manage your purchase orders. To best illustrate this point, we will record three purchase orders. June 5th ordered 65 apples from Addie's Orchard. From the main menu, Vendors, Create Purchase Order. June 5th, purchase order number one, Addie's Orchard. The item is apples and the quantity is 65. Save and New will bring you to the next purchase order. The next purchase order is June 6th, ordered 85 bananas from Sam's Farm. So, June 6th, Sam's Farm. Bananas, 85. Save and New to go to the next purchase order. June 7, ordered 95 bananas from Addie's Orchard. June 7, Addie's Orchard, bananas, 85. Save and close, and now you can see that the open purchase order detail separates the purchase orders by item, and of course gives you all the details of the quantity on the order, how many were received, how many back ordered, and the amount. Now let's see what happens when we receive some of these items. June 8th receives the 65 apples from Addie's Orchard from purchase order number 1. We received it with bill number 4455 from Addie. Of course, we go to Vendors, Receive Items, and Enter Bill. At the moment we choose Addie's Orchard, we get this message. This message is a normal part of QuickBooks. It is not an error message, and you did not make a mistake. You are supposed to read this message and understand that the vendor whom you are receiving merchandise from has open purchase orders, and QuickBooks is asking you if the merchandise you receive today, June 8th, is merchandise from one of those orders. When we click yes, we have a choice of which of the orders from Addie's Orchard we are receiving the merchandise from. In this case, it's number 1, so we click on order number 1, And when we click OK, all of the information from order number one comes here on the screen. Of course, it's June, I believe it's June 8th is the day we physically receive this merchandise. And the bill number is bill number 4455. Now, it says over here in this corner, this is from purchase order number one. So after we save this bill as evidence of receiving the items, save and close, now we look on the open purchase order report and we see purchase order number one is no longer on this report at all, because purchase order number one is no longer a purchase, an open purchase order. It is not an open purchase order if it has been received. Now let's take a look at the more interesting one. June 9th, received only 40 of the 85 bananas ordered from Sam's Farm on purchase order number two. And we received it with the bill. So we received from Sam's Farm one of the orders, but only some of them. We click vendor, receive items, and enter bill. The date is June 9th. The bill number is 6677. Look what happens at the moment we choose Sam's Farm. Ah, we get this normal message reminding us that we have open purchase orders and that this bill is from one of those orders. We should click yes to get the open purchase order list just for Sam's Farm. As you can see, there's only one purchase order open for Sam's Farm. Let's choose it and click OK. Now, QuickBooks assumes that all of the information from purchase order number two should be copied directly to the bill. You are the bookkeeper. You know that the proper quantity we received is only 40. So we push tab and that adjusts the amount of the bill to the amount that we really owe for what we physically received. So we ordered 85, but we only received 40, and the money amount adjusts down for this specific bill and this specific item receipt. Click save and close, and now we look at the open purchase order detail. You can see for purchase order number two, you can see that the quantity was 85. We received 40. Therefore, what's back ordered is 45. The total amount of the order is $1,700, and the open balance, meaning the amount that we did not receive, is 45 times the cost of the bananas, which is $900. Students will sometimes ask, is there a specific report for closed purchase orders? There is no specific report for closed purchase orders, but there are two ways that you can see all purchase orders, regardless of whether they're open or closed. You can use the advanced find to see all purchase orders and export that into a report, or you could use the transaction list by vendors to see all of the open purchase or all of the purchase orders, regardless of whether they're open or closed, but they're organized by vendor. So we can click edit find, and then in the simple transaction tab, choose purchase order and click find. Here are all of the purchase orders regardless. We can export them into a report. And then this way you can double click and you can see this one is still open. You can double click and see this one is received in full. You can also open the transaction list by vendor, reports, vendors and payables, transaction list by vendor. Push A for all, and you can see Addie's Orchard had two purchase orders here. Number three is still open, and number one is received in full. And though that would be two ways to see all purchase orders, and then you can sort through them one by one to see which ones are open and which ones are closed.